bass.
Oh yes, big.
Big fish.
But no matter what you've caught, or even what you've seen, there is always a bigger fish, a tougher fish.
Shark, got it.
And it's out there. It's out there somewhere. Just out here in the Atlantic Ocean, there's been some huge blue marlin caught. There's been big yellowfin tuna, an impressive number of a whole array of species, including wahoo and sailfish. And there could be a whole lot more. The thing is, because it's such a frontier, no one's really explored it. We don't know what we're going to encounter. But something tells me this is going to be pretty good. I've never before fished in this remote corner of the Atlantic Ocean. And now here we are at our exotic destination, Principe Island. And we waste no time getting on the boat and heading out to see what we can find. Well, here we go. We're off out into the Atlantic Ocean in search of that perfect day's fishing, of that fish of a lifetime. What that is, I don't know. But if you are going to get a fish of a lifetime, might as well be right here, Principe. Captain Bert Beauchard has put together this whole operation. He's set up a lodge on the beach, has an immaculate sport fishing vessel, and assembled a crew. So not only can we explore these waters, we can do it in absolute comfort and style. So for starters, we just put out a spread of marlin lures, and after days of travel, it takes just minutes for a marlin to show up.
On the left.
He's on you!
Yeah, you've got him.
Yes, sir.
He's got him.
Yeah!
Oh, that didn't take long at all. Oh, yeah, there she goes. Out there, Dan.
Woo-hoo!
Oh, look at her go. Yeah!
Come on!
Look at this reel.
Matt, are you okay?
I'm good, bro, I'm good.
Matt, can I go for it?
Yeah, you can go for it, bro. They're jumping way out there. Look at him go, way out there.
One. Yeehaw! We're only going 7 knots.
Way out there, look at him go, way out there. So we're chasing this fish down. It's taking a whole lot of line. A whole lot of line.
Okay, let's go.
Go. It's going on. So we're backing down now. We're trying to get this fish quickly.
Barely got the lure set. Sorry, I couldn't say much throughout all of that. It was all on. You would have seen the commotion when a blue marlin bites and all the boys are all peeking, mate, primed for it. It gets exciting.
Yeah, just so we can get better audio.
Okay, clicker off. Okay, so now that this fish has settled down, it went on an incredible run there and we just had to get the boat going backwards fast. One, so we didn't lose too much line. And two, we want to get this fish as fast as we can so it ends up at the boat in good condition so we can release it. It was full on.
Told you I wasn't talking it up. I'm not talking about these blues. Brilliant.
Leader. Leader.
Leader's right here, mate.
Woohoo! Drone is operational.
Jump, buddy.
Okay. Over there, bro. Swim. Swim to him, bro. Oh, super action hero team.
I'm forward on port side. Forward on port side. Go for it, Bobby.
He's right. He's close to us, bro. So. Okay, he's got the leader now. Just going to shorten him up. Hopefully, we can get a pin into this fish. Get the hooks out. Yeah. You just tell me. Oh, there it is. Blue marlin. Watch that rigger, bro. Whoa.
I can't do anything for you now. Forward.
Forward.
I'm neutral, Bobby.
Get a bit closer, bro.
Bring it.
Gain. Gain. We've had a drone, bit of a drone malfunction. Back to the fish. Oh, yes. Yep. Thank you. Oh, there it is. Well, I had to wait, what? 10 minutes. First Atlantic blue marlin I've ever caught.
Mark, you want to put a tag in it?
And what a fish. Yeah, I'd love to tag it, mate. There we go. Good work, team. Yeah, okay, we want a nice clean release, guys.
There we go.
Yeah, tagged and released. Yeah. Thank you, Bert.
Pleasure.
All right.
Good to have you on board, boys. Nice.
Well done. Thanks, bro. What a slick team.
Good team.
Nice
slick
one,
team.
Guys. Nice one.
Thanks, man. Okay, well, let's get Kane and go get that drone. Might be in the hot water cupboard tonight, mate.
Yeah.
Blast!
It's a semi-submersible.
Yeah, we have fish all right. We got them on. Oh, look at that. It's an amberjack, isn't it? Oh, that's right. Oh, man, we're getting owned. Oh, he's going to rub me off on the barrel, is he? Oh, that was big here. That was big here, bro. Oh.
So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app, so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv. We're fishing in the Atlantic Ocean off the tiny West African island of Principe. We've immediately caught a blue marlin on heavy tackle.
Yeehaw! Woo!
But now, I'm rigging up some lighter gear that I've brought halfway around the world to target everything from giant snapper and amberjack on the reef to the blue marlin and tuna that patrol the deep blue water out here beyond the drop.
We got fulu, it's on.
Now, Bert upstairs has spotted a local fish called a pulupulu, which from what we gather is a small variety of tuna. And Bobby has rigged up this here, it's like a daisy chain to really get them fired up. The one at the back, of course, the straggler, has got the hook in it. This is gonna do the trick for us, is it, Bob?
Hope so. I think we're gonna get something now.
Okay. The guys here are predominantly lure fishermen, and well, because it works, but I'm always keen to catch a locally sourced bait and then feed it to the big predators, because after all, that's what they're out here naturally eating, these things here. Oh, beautiful, look at it. So fulu, yeah? Fulu, we occasionally catch these in New Zealand, known as kawakawa, obviously a small tuna, and that would just be like a little, beautiful little jelly bean for a blue marlin. Okay, Capitan, we've got our teasers out. What's the game plan today?
We got sunshine, which is good.
So
So let's go for marlin, and I guess you guys want to do some jigging as well?
Yeah, well, I mean, I brought the gear, some jigging gear, some popping gear.
You remember that rock right there in Galley?
Yeah.
So we go there, we go on the lee side of that of Galley, and go for big red snappers.
Big red snappers. Now, how big do these snappers get? I've heard talk that they're...
Well, listen, I've been spearfishing that place, and I think the biggest one I've seen is around 30 kilos. But I believe Bobby has raised some much bigger fish.
Oh, you've got me even more amped than I already was. Look at this place. Right, I better man the stations. I've got a bait to pitch if we raise a marlin, which we're going to do very shortly. Decided he didn't want it and spat it out.
Okay, you can give it a go here, guys.
Kurt's marking them on the sounder. He's just said 45 metres down. I've got my Power Pro Depth Hunter braid, which is multicoloured. Okay, I've just gone to 40 metres there, 50 there. I'm going to go a little deeper and I'm going to jig back up through them. Jigging with a spinning reel isn't something that I'm really accustomed to, but do it a few times, you get a feel for it. Got him. Got him on over here. He's got him on. Woohoo! Yeah, let's see one of these bad boys. Go, Bob. Oh, yeah, I just had a shot. Yeah, I got him. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I got him all right. Or has he got me? Woo-hoo! Oh, no, I dropped him. Mate, that one I had on was a good fish, bro. That was pulling hard.
Not so big. Could be a small amber or a almaco.
There you go. He's just mentioned two fish I've never caught before. That excites me. Yeah, we have fish all right. We got them on. Oh, look at that. That's an amberjack, is it?
Nice fish.
Oh, yeah. What a mean looking fish. Okay. Beautiful. It's almost like Trevally snapper kingfish clone.
Okay. Let him go.
Yeah, you gonna let him go?
Yeah.
Here we go, we got colour. Here she comes, and it's gonna be a first for me. An amberjack! Hey! I don't think it's anywhere near as big as that first one that bit. There she is, what a cool fish! Far out, amazing colours. I know this is probably stock standard for you guys, but this is just so new to me. What a stunning, hard-fighting fish. And you can eat them too, yeah?
Yeah, super eating.
Super eating. So are we going to let this guy go?
We can keep him for the pot for tonight.
We can keep him. I'd love to try one.
Dinner tonight.
You can put it in the live well if you want there.
Yeah,
right,
we'll
there.
Keep him cool in the live well.
Okay, great. I'd love to eat one. Far out. Thank you, guys. Yeah.
Oh, we can do more, eh?
Yeah, we're going to do more, all right. Oh, yeah, we're going to do more. Oh, yeah, he's got him. Oh, yeah, I'm on. Yours a smaller one too, Bob? Oh, yeah, there it is there.
Okay.
That's different from the amberjack, is it?
No, it's a juvenile amber.
Okay, one goes back, another one comes in. Far out, they're like little trevallies. So there's no size limits here then, I'm guessing?
Oh, listen, we're in Africa, so it's common sense.
Eating, and this will be a good eating size, this one?
This, sashimi-wise, will be quite appreciated by everybody tonight, I'm pretty sure.
Sold. This guy is going to be killed and going on ice. You had me at sashimi. Oh, I forgot him.
Yes, sir.
Oh, loving it. Oh. There we go. Here's another one. Amberjack. There he is. Man, they're solid. Thick set. Love the gnarly colours on them. He's going home.
Straight in the camera.
Thank you, Bert.
Pleasure.
Oh, Bobby's on, right? Oh, ruthless. There's some load on there, bro.
Give me a bucket, please, Nicole, there on the floor.
Oh, no, everyone's a bit busy, mate, sorry. Here we go. Oh, man, that pulled hard. Oh, it's a bit better, bro. It's a bit better. Hey, what a cool fish, man. What a cool fish. Right, you want to sling this one back?
Yeah.
It's right, I got him, mate. I used to be a crewman for a little bit, you know. I used to do this for a job.
Thanks, Matt.
There you go, mate. Look at that. You want to hold them?
No, thank you,
man. Oh, dime a dozen for you, eh?
No, it's too small to hold.
Yeah, too small to hold. That's all right, mate. That's all right. It's not too small for me. Okay. Straight at him. Beautiful. Love it. We're making a TV show now. You see, just typically we make a fishing show and it needs fish, so this is really good.
Classic.
Nico's trying to catch some bait for us with his bait flies. I'd be so keen to put live bait down here. I would be so keen. Uh-oh, those sabikis. What do we got here? Oh, one of these little guys, and he's weaved a basket. Now, I've got to do this quickly because that wee bait that Nico caught is a tuna. Tuna do not stay alive in bait tanks. Now, this is my patented rig that I've just made up here with a few bits and bobs. Got him, get him upside down, bro. Do you think one of these amberjack will eat this guy?
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, brilliant.
For sure. Or a big snapper or anything else.
Let's get him in there.
Okay, am I dropping now?
Yeah.
Drop. And he's still alive too, awesome. So dropping down now, we've got a live bait going 65 metres down with a rig that I kind of just made up on the spot. We've got no lead on board, so we've tied two jigs together for a weight. We've got a live tuna. Never tried to rig anything like it. This will be interesting. See if something will eat it. Oh man, I want something to eat that bait. Could be too cool for words. Oh, I just don't know what's down there really. Big amberjack, one of these giant snapper thingies that I've never seen. Yellowfin tuna might eat it. Marlin might eat it. Love it. That anticipation. Bait's peeking out. Oh yeah, I'm bit. Yeah, I'm bit. Something's eating this bait, dude.
Yes.
Oh, Holy something's eating it.
Do you want me to move the boat or you're okay?
I think I... Oh! Got me into the reef, bro. Oh. That's 100-pound fluorocarbon too.
I wanted to see what that was! Yo, Nico, give me another bait, bro!
Oh, man!
I could have been a grouper.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It was big, whatever it was. Oh, yeah! Got him! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa, what a bike! Oh, a lot of drag on there, and that's pulling some serious line.
Hey, hey, Marlon, man! Marlon!
Yeah, yeah, right, on the left, on the left, on the left! Where is he?
He's on you! Yes,
yeah,
sir!
He's got it,
Bert's really screwing this boat around. The boat's bearing down, we're making ground now.
What?
This morning we're starting our day a little bit different in that we're trying to catch bait. Now, that's not unusual for me. Back at home, I always like to catch fresh bait in the morning. But here, they mainly fish with lures. But I can't help wonder what it was that ate my live bait the other day. So, we're gonna get some more baits, and we're gonna give it another shot today and see if we can't turn up a big fish here in Principe using a few Kiwi techniques. Oh, yellow, got him off.
Whoa, whoa.
Might be a rainbow runner.
Maybe a bigger rainbow runner.
Yeah.
Possibly, yeah.
Careful. Oh, is it a... It's a bigger kawakawa. It's a trophy. Oh, that's going to make beautiful strip baits.
Well, I've never seen bait like this. It's unbelievable. It's tick, 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 tick.
Are we making bait? Yes, we're making bait.
What do you call a fusilier?
Well, I've never seen one of those baits before, but local bait fish. Local big fish. Oh, I just had a little touch there. Yep, got them on. Hey, look at those little guys. Fusiliers, yeah? Yeah, got them on. Well, bait fishing done. Going after the big stuff. Okay, here we go. Time to put a live bait out. Now, we don't have any sinkers, so I'm using a jig as a sinker, which is a Lumo sinker, so I might attract some attention, and a Fusilier live bait. Whole new rig for me.
Come on, someone smoke this live bait.
Oh, yeah, he's got him. He's got him. Oh, yeah, he's got him. How far up off the bottom were you? Oh, yeah.
Right on the bottom.
Tighten up if you want, bro. How you like that little anarchy rod?
Beautiful.
Yeah,
absolutely beautiful rod. Right?
Oh yeah, go toe to toe. Come on, get him. Is he in the reef, is he?
Felt something.
Move him out. Keep him moving, bro. Keep him moving. There you go, you got him moving. Oh yeah, nice amber. Nice one, mate. Oh yeah, what a scrap you got out of this beast.
Yeah!
That's a nice one, man. Oh, man.
That's the biggest one I've seen this year.
It's the biggest one you've seen this year?
Yes, yeah,
for sure. Far out, that's a nice fish.
One this year. Nice fish.
Gives you an idea of the size of some of those ones that were smoking us. Come on. There you go, look at that. Okay, we'll let this guy go, yeah? Woo, we're all right. Now, one of these giant snappers is what we want though. Next, some fish line, that's what we needed. Get our mojo going. Oh, that got hit hard, man.
I did tell you we had fish.
That got hit hard, man.
That came from the bottom of the heart, eh?
Ooh, there's a lot of drag on there, I can tell you that much. Whoa. That's right, I'm supposed to be talking. This Saragossa 10,000 can apply a lot of drag. And it's really required at the moment just to keep this fish away from that sharp reef down there. Just gotta get line when you can and try and get away from that danger zone down at the bottom. I tell you what, I'm gonna have a bruise right there on my thigh. That'd be so worth it. Nothing like a few fishing battle scars. A reminder, a souvenir of my trip to Principe. Okay, here we go, we've got a leader here. Oh yeah, it's a good one. Another goodie.
Nice one.
Cheers, mate.
Yes, yes.
Oh, look at me, what a cool fish. How many kilos is that guy there?
I don't know, about 15, man.
15 kilo?
I reckon about 15, yeah.
Look at them, what an awesome fish. Oh, look, they've even got the strong caudal keel, almost like a tuna. Kink, but they're, oh, look at the colours coming out on this guy. Part of the Seriola family. Okay, guy, you're going home. Yeah, that's what we need to get the blood pumping. Bit of blue marlin warm up. We only caught two decent sized Fusilier live baits. One of them's been eaten by we don't know what. So this is the last one. Hopefully, that big old snapper. Oh, hello, that's got some get up and go. It's got him bent over the rail. Oh, tight. Oh man, we're getting owned. Just keep driving. Oh yeah, no, we're moving him now.
Go, Bobby, go.
Nice big boy. Oh, yes. That's a nicey boy.
Whoa.
Oh man, it's got some weight in it. That is a weighty fish. Oh yeah. You want to grab that camera, bro? We've got to get a photo. Oh, it's had you in the reef too. That's where this Oshia fluorocarbon is so valuable. This amberjack has dragged it right through the reef. And look, we're still connected. We've still got him.
Let it be a snapper, please let it be a snapper. Oh.
Gimbal belt, please. The live bait's been eaten as well. We're trying to get some photos. Oh, it's a different fight anyway. Ooh. Oh. Oh man, what is it? I can feel it, it's like the big head nods. It's like a snapper. Boom, 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 you can see it on the rod there. But it's an amberjack. A live bait caught amberjack, so it is different. It was caught on a live bait. Hey, there's the bait right there in the corner of his mouth. There you go, our patented rig work, Bobby. Oh, nice stuff. I'll tell you what, I don't tire of catching those. Well, not physically, I'm starting to tire, but it's not getting old. What a great fish. This is a neat sport fishery to have on your doorstep just to break up your blue marlin fishing, Bobby. Yeah?
Definitely so.
I guess we'll keep on fishing because this is no snapper.
See you later, buddy. Hopefully you're not the last fish I see here. Now, just a wee trick here. Because I like that strip bait to have the hook just through the end so I can wave around enticingly. The trouble is though, with not much meat there, it can tear out. So I've got a rubber band. I've wrapped it around the bait, crisscrossed it and onto the hook. So that's holding on really firmly. There's no way a fish is going to pluck that off, yet it can still be presented naturally. Oh, he's getting bit. I'm getting bit. Yeah, something's got this bait. Strip bait got eaten straight away. Woo-hoo-hoo! It's good to be hooked up. What have we got? One of those guys. So amberjacks take strip baits too, it would seem.
What should we do now?
What are our options?
Well, marlin.
Yeah.
Keep on jigging. Go popping in galley.
What are we likely to get if we go popping?
A red snapper.
Yeah?
Mm.
Oh man, if we go and do that, are we going to have another chance to come back and do this again? For me to get that big amberjack, one of these ones?
Well, there's always tomorrow.
Ah, there is too.
But what we could do though is we could marlin fishing up to galley.
Yeah.
And fold the riggers and the marlin stuff and then finish the day popping.
Through the motions. I haven't been this anxious about a marlin in such a long time. After catching as many as I've had, it doesn't wear off, man. This is exciting. Woo! Okay, we got good weight here, Bert. It's got a slow take. Let's go, let's catch this fish. Get a pin in him and send him on his way.
Marlin on surface.
It's right up on the surface. Get ready for some jumps, bro.
Marlin on surface.
Smoking, literally. Look how thin that line is. And we're fishing for blue marlin.
Let's go for it.
Okay, we're on mono. We've got mono, we're close. Oh, there he is. Look at his tail ripping through the water. He's over here. Bert's really screwing this boat around. That's where the boatmanship really comes into it. This marlin's doing all sorts of direction changes. It's charging around on the surface. Bert's maneuvering the boat to try and keep up with it. You can see his tail ripping through the water there. And we're just trying to get it as fast as we can. Get a hold of that leader and get a tag in. Woo! It's cutting up the water. You can see that tail cutting it up. Okay, you've got him. He's got the leader now, so officially it's a caught fish. Oh yeah, boy! Tag, where's the tag hole? a hot one, man. Got him fast, got him away fast. That's like the ultimate. Circle hook in the corner of the mouth just popped off. Hot fish. And that is why we come all this way. That's why people travel all around the world to do this. And what a wonderful use of a resource. You can see already the amount of value it's bringing to Principe. And I'd come all that way again for that experience. Thank you very much, fellas. That was awesome, eh?
That was cool.
Right, let's go again. Snapper that eats a stick bait on the surface and something smashed it. We don't know what. It was big and it was silver. It's, oh, and it pulls hard. Oh, it pulls hard. I've just got so much drag on here because just like our snapper at home, I'm told these things just power down to the reef, so you've got to try and stop them. Except the difference being is these things get up to 60 kilos. There's a lot of drag on there, and that's pulling some serious line. Oh, what is it? A big barracuda, is it? Oh, wicked! Oh, yeah, got him! Good gaff shot, bro. Yeah, look at him! What a beast!
Nice one.
Hey, and he smoked my stick bait now. The barracuda. C-U-D-A, Cuda, is not to be confused with the barracuda that we get in New Zealand. A real pest in New Zealand. These guys, the barracuda in the tropics, are great eating. And this one, will we take him back to eat him, you think?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Look at that, oh, I'd love a photo with that thing. And of course, just like our barracuda, we think our barracuda have got teeth. Check out the teeth on this guy here. Someone grab some stills, eh? I'll get a couple of pics. Yeah. Pitch is done. Chef wanted some fish because letting marlin go doesn't help his cause. Doesn't help the local villagers either that are hungry for some fish. So this guy here is going in with our amberjack. Thanks, man. Wicked. Got the slimy handshake down. We got it down, bro.
Yes, 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 yes.
There's mahi under it?
Yes.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Give me mahi, mahi for tonight, man. I love you a long time.
Oh, I've got a hit. I've got a hit then.
Try a bit faster. No, they're not calling you. They don't like that lure, man. Not interested.
Going out to change lures. Now what we have here is basically an old barrel, and that is working just like a fad. Oh, were they on it then? Oh,
they're all over it.
Yep.
Yes, oh, sir.
Got him.
Yay! Winner!
Oh, jumping.
Chef will be really happy.
Hey, don't talk about eating it yet. No one talk about eating it. Have we got that gaff? Is he on good enough?
Big ones. Big ones in there, boy.
I was just about to say, aren't the mahi-mahi your beautiful, glorious-looking fish?
Is the chef going to be happy tonight?
Chef is going to be happy, isn't he? We've got a real smorgasbord, don't we? Bit of variety. I just want one of those big mahi now. Well, there you go. We've come across, spotted that barrel. We took the opportunity. We went over. There's mahi there. Had a little lure ready. Didn't work. Changed the lure and straight away they bit it. That seems to be the case. Not just mahi mahi, so many fish. You cast a couple of times, they don't eat it. Change up the lure. And the one that worked this time is just a little wee pink orca stick bait. Right, where are they? Once I hook up. Oh yeah, straight away. Smoke them! Hey! Oh, loving it!
Oh, he's taking line, this one. Oh, hey! Oh, he's gonna rub me off on the barrel, is he? Oh, that was big ear. That was big ear, bro. Whoa. Tell me you guys got that. Yeah. Yeah. He jumped the barrel. Chef is gonna be happy, boys. Oh, yeah, it's a better one, too. Might want to gaff this one, maybe, do you think?
Looks like a nice bull.
Look at those colours. That's what I was talking about. Those stunning colours of the mahi-mahi. At the moment, he's got his blue, green, and gold colours on. They can change to pink, silver in an instant. They're lightning fast. An incredible fish. Incredible fish. Rightio, you just going to grab him, bro? Okay, just be careful, everybody, when he comes aboard. There's lots of hooks there. Oh, is he gonna get in? Is he gonna come in the boat? He is gonna come in the boat. Yeah, that one's a bit better again.
You got amberjack, barracuda, dorado.
I'm happy. Chef's happy.
Need to come back for snappers.
Oh, snapper! There you go.
Sashimi time. Let's go.
Well, that's not a bad little catch. And I know that there's going to be somebody very pleased to see these fish here. I'll take this little sashimi number. There you go, chef.
Oi, how are you?
Whoa. I am very good.
Catch fish here, really
yes,
nice fish today.
Yes, yes. This one good. Here, we bled it for sashimi.
Really?
And kept it cold for sashimi?
I will prepare now, just now, believe me.
Oh, beautiful. This one here, Dorado.
It's Dorado, for nice for grill.
Oh, beautiful.
Believe me.
We've got more there, we've got more Dorado.
Oh, lemon, yeah, butter, and garlic like sauce in the top of this fish. Woo!
Amazing. How good is that? Barely back in from the water, ready to jump in a hot shower, have a cold beer. Chef's already onto the sashimi. Hey, woo, all right.
After a big day on the water, this was the perfect way to cap it off.
And this is
fresh fish.
What's in your sauce here, chef?
Soya and cayenne, believe it, it's just delicious.
Oh yeah, it is delicious. If you've enjoyed this episode of Ultimate Fishing with Matt Watson, chances are you're gonna wanna see some more. Well, we've got you covered at ultimatefishing.tv, where we've got fishing action filmed from all around the world, big boats, small boats, all kinds of tackle and fish, advertising free. It's all covered at ultimatefishing.tv, or you can download the free Ultimate Fishing app.